Let's start with this easiest mistake to avoid with this integral here, and then we'll move on to other problems in this video where the mistakes you're making are harder and harder to see. Now with this integral, when I do a u substitution, I would let u equal x squared plus 4, and then du would be 2x dx after taking the derivative of both sides. And then when I plug in u into the original problem, this leaves me with a very simple polynomial to integrate. Now the problem here is that after you do so, a lot of you think that this is your answer, but you forgot to go back to the variable x. You can't leave a u in here because I didn't give you a u in the original problem. Now let's move on to the next one where it's a little bit trickier to see what you're doing wrong. Say I gave you this function f of x. Now, if you were to be asked on an exam to find its derivative and you started doing so, there's nothing wrong with that. And if you watch my videos, you're going to be crushing this kind of problem and getting the right answer. But that's going to slow you down. You can actually save time on this derivative if you first simplify f of x. And believe it or not, you won't even need to use the product rule. Because with f of x, since it's a natural log of a product, remember that you can rewrite a natural log of a product this way. And check this out. The natural log of e to the something is that something. And for natural log of x cubed, I can bring that power 3 out in front. And you can even look at this visually and very quickly figure out what the derivative is. It's going to give you this. And if you want even more practice on mistakes to avoid, you can check out the videos I'm leaving above for each of these problems. And you can even go in the description because I'm giving you guys a free study guide with 10 simple mistakes to avoid on your exam. Moving on to the next one, an even harder mistake that we can easily fall for. Now, with this limit problem, actually has a couple of mistakes in one. For one, if you plug in 2 here, you'll notice that you'll have an expression that looks like 0 divided by 0. Many of you will automatically assume the limit doesn't exist, which isn't true. But then some of you will try L'Hopital's rule to see if it exists. And a lot of times we even use that wrong. But in this particular problem, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and factor the denominator. And you'll have x minus 2 here, both on the top and the bottom. So it seems logical to cancel x minus 2 from both the top and bottom, right? And here's the problem. You have an absolute value sign up here. So you actually have to look at the behavior of what's happening with that expression when you approach the value of 2 for x from the left, and then when you approach it from the right. So you really should break up this limit into 2 separate piecewise problems. Okay, moving on to the next one. For this function here, f of x, it's kind of related to the one above. It's really relating to a domain problem, right? Now, if I were to give you this expression here, and I again asked you to find what the derivative is, what we would want to do first is take f of x and factor the top, where I have x minus 3 times x plus 2 now. Now, the problem here is, let's just say you went ahead and canceled x minus 3 on the top and bottom, giving you this expression. And then when you find the derivative of this, you're going to use the product rule and you're going to come up with something that looks like this. And after combining the terms, you say that this is your final answer. And by inspection, if we're only dealing with real numbers, we know this denominator can never be 0, right? And so you might be saying, oh, well, the domain for this derivative function is that it's continuous everywhere and that all real values of x are allowed. Here's the problem. Do you remember how when we did our simplification up here, as I'm scrolling up to show you, we canceled out x minus 3 on the top and bottom here? We need to look at what's considered to be a removable discontinuity, because what's happening here is this is already assuming that with the original f of x function, you were domain restricted, because even if you cancel out terms, if you were to graph what I gave you originally, the value of x equals 3 is not allowed. You would have a hole in your graph. So always remember that. So when you have a derivative like this, and you say that this is your final answer here, you need to add something that says, hey, the value of x here cannot be 3. Okay, so now moving on to the final problem. This one is the easiest one to fall for, and I'm sure I'm going to get blasted in the comments by a lot of you. But here we have the squeeze limit. This is a common squeeze theorem problem, right? And many of you will try and solve this using L'Hopital's rule. And even though you get the correct answer, there's a big mistake with using L'Hopital's rule here, unless you actually understand where it came from. L'Hopital's rule came from the squeeze theorem limit. And so it's circular reasoning to use L'Hopital's rule to blindly solve this without understanding what you're doing, because it already assumes that you know what the derivative of the sine of x is.